Welcome back to Bad Things in History, where sometimes we can't believe the insane ideas people have carried out throughout history. Nuclear weapons are dangerous and frightening. A war fought with these terrible devices would end human civilization. Despite the threat posed by this technology, the United States and Soviet Union combined have detonated slightly less than 2,000 nuclear bombs. The reason they exploded hundreds of nuclear devices is simple yet terrifying. For a brief moment, scientists, politicians, and generals were united in a common cause. They wanted more data. As people became concerned about what radiation might do to the environment, those in charge of creating these weapons of mass destruction had an idea. If they could convince the public that nuclear weapons could be used for peaceful purposes, then perhaps everybody could learn to love the technology. Today we are going to tell you the strange story of how the United States and Soviet Union planned to create a more peaceful world by detonating nuclear weapons. Father of the Hydrogen Bomb. Edward Teller was born in Budapest on January 15, 1908. His mother was a pianist. Edward's father earned a living by practicing law. Little did they know that their son would one day help create the most destructive weapon in human history. On July 14, 1928, Edward was a student at the University of Munich. He decided to use a streetcar to catch a ride to a nearby train. The train would then take him to the Alps, where he would spend the day hiking. Unfortunately, Edward decided to jump off the streetcar while it was still moving. He fell, and one of the wheels severed most of his right foot. At first, he took medication to deal with the pain, but Edward soon realized that he couldn't think clearly while under the influence of narcotics. So he stopped taking medication and learned to live with constant pain. This resilience would serve him well later in life. In 1935, he was invited to become a professor of physics at George Washington University. While there, he predicted the Jan Teller effect, which was very important in the fields of chemistry and particle physics. It also ensured that he was considered one of the most brilliant minds of his generation. Edward was also a very difficult person to tolerate. By 1942, Robert Oppenheimer was in the process of creating a team to work on the Manhattan Project. He wanted to find the most brilliant minds and then convince them to create the atomic bomb. Oppenheimer held a planning seminar at the University of California, Berkeley, where several famous physicists attended. Edward was also present. However, he wasn't really interested in making a simple atomic bomb. The early versions of these weapons created fission reactions, which split atoms and released an immense amount of energy. Edward thought a fusion bomb would be larger and more impressive. Most of Edward's colleagues thought the idea of a fusion bomb was ridiculous. However, Edward persisted. With the help of several colleagues, he helped create the first fusion bomb in 1952. It was at least 1,000 times more powerful than the previous generation of fission bombs. Edward also tried to take full credit for the discovery. By 1954, Robert Oppenheimer was in trouble. There were rumors that he was becoming too friendly with communists. When the government decided to review Oppenheimer's security clearance, Edward Teller was asked to testify. He told the government that they should revoke Oppenheimer's clearance. Ultimately, officials agreed and Oppenheimer's access was revoked. Although the final decision probably had little to do with Edward's testimony, many of his colleagues were not forgiving of this transgression. Edward found that he was no longer welcomed in the world of academia. But he continued to work for the government, and he found a new mission. Edward decided to dedicate his time and energy to finding peaceful uses for nuclear weapons. Project Plowshare. On December 8, 1953, President Eisenhower gave a speech in front of the United Nations. It was called Atoms for Peace. He hoped to take nuclear weapons and convert them to a tool that the world could use for peaceful pursuits. Part of his speech mentioned plans. The United States knows that if the fearful trend of atomic military buildup can be reversed, this greatest of destructive forces can be developed into a great boon for the benefit of all mankind. The United States knows that peaceful power from atomic energy is no dream of the future. The capability, already proved, is here today. Who can doubt that if the entire body of the world's scientists and engineers had adequate amounts of fissionable material with which to test and develop their ideas, this capability would rapidly be transformed into universal, efficient, and economic usage? Edward Teller agreed with Eisenhower's position. Instead of letting the planet live in fear, he hoped that it might be possible to use nuclear power to save the world. In February 1957, a symposium was held at Livermore National Laboratory. Several ideas were presented for how nuclear weapons might be used, but the scientists quickly concluded they needed more data to determine how to do it. Everybody agreed that it was a good idea, if it could be done. So in June 1957, Project Plowshare was officially organized. Those working on the project were tasked with testing peaceful applications for nuclear weapons. On September 9, 1957, the United States performed the first underground nuclear test. Scientists examined the site of the explosion once it was safe to do so. They soon concluded it was possible to use nuclear explosions in a way that wouldn't destroy civilization. Soon there were several proposals for how to use these incredibly violent weapons. One idea suggested using nuclear detonations to widen the Panama Canal. Some scientists thought that bombs could be used to create harbors and canals faster and more safely than traditional construction methods. One suggestion even proposed detonating bombs underground in Arizona so that water aquifers could be connected. Most of the ideas never happened. Some almost happened, and a few did become reality. The first place to take the idea seriously was Alaska. Project Chariot. In 1958, the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission proposed the creation of a new harbor in Cape Thompson, Alaska. Those who created the plan wanted to place nuclear weapons underground. When detonated, the giant crater could then be used as a harbor. Edward Teller was enthusiastic in his support of the plan. He traveled all over Alaska informing residents that creating the new harbor would increase economic activity in the state. Politicians, community leaders, and even churches voiced their support for the plan. In 1960, an editorial in the Fairbanks News Miner said, "We think the holding of a huge nuclear blast in Alaska would be a fitting overture to the new era which is opening for our state." The natives who lived in Alaska were skeptical of the ideas put forth by Teller. Eventually, conservationist groups became aware of what was happening and began protesting all over the country. In 1962, the United States government announced that they wouldn't move forward with the plan. Never wanting to waste an opportunity, officials decided that they needed a better understanding of how radioactive contamination worked. Alaska, it seemed, was a good place to make that discovery. In August 1962, contaminated material from Nevada was brought to the Project Chariot site. The goal was to determine how radioactivity might affect water and food sources. After performing several experiments, the waste was buried at the Project Chariot site. The nearest community was in Point Hope. The native residents were never told of the toxic waste buried nearby. About 30 years later, a researcher at University of Alaska found where the nuclear waste was located. Tests showed that the soil was radioactive to a depth of 2 feet. In the 30 years since the waste was deposited, the native residents of Point Hope also experienced high rates of cancer. After public outrage over the incident, the United States government removed the waste and deposited it elsewhere. Project Gnome. In 1958, Project Gnome was announced. The goal was to test nuclear weapons to see if any of the Project Plowshare proposals were feasible. A single underground explosion was planned near Carlsbad, New Mexico. Researchers intended to study it to discover whether the heat from a nuclear explosion could be used to generate electricity. They also wanted to see if radioactive isotopes could be recovered and used for scientific and medical purposes. Finally, scientists wanted to study neutrons to better understand how to build safe nuclear reactors. It was already known that when a nuclear bomb explodes underground, most of the isotopes are trapped in the rock. To try and avoid this pitfall, the Gnome explosion took place in a salt deposit. A tunnel was created to provide access to the test site. The nuclear device was then placed 1,184 feet underground. The United States government wanted to help the public become more comfortable with how safe nuclear detonations could be. So, on December 10, 1961, several civilians were invited to watch. This included reporters, scientists, and even some residents from Carlsbad. When the bomb exploded, events didn't go according to plan. Smoke and steam emerged from the detonation site and released radiation. It dispersed quickly, but those closest to the tunnel had more exposure than planned. The bomb also destroyed the underground cavern by causing a collapse. 6 months after the explosion, the temperature inside the cavern was still 140 degrees Fahrenheit. However, it was considered safe, so scientists entered the cavern and began collecting data. Ultimately, the test did help with learning how to detect nuclear explosions, but it didn't produce electricity and none of the isotopes were recovered. Project Plowshare resulted in 26 additional nuclear tests. Most of them were designed to determine whether nuclear bombs could help with accessing natural gas and oil. The tests did show that it might be feasible, but the potential risks outweighed any benefits. The last nuclear explosion for Project Plowshare took place in 1973. The project formally ended in 1977. Nuclear explosions for the national economy. The USSR also realized that nuclear weapons may have uses other than destroying property and people. Their program was more extensive than Project Plowshare and, in many ways, more successful. Early on, the Soviet program was like its counterpart in the United States. Tests were performed to see if nuclear explosions were useful for excavations. Nuclear detonations were also used for oil extraction. After finding some initial success, interest in the program skyrocketed. The Soviets performed 156 tests between 1965 and 1989. Five of the explosions were also used for more practical purposes. Nuclear detonations were one way the Soviet government extinguished natural gas fires. Although the program appeared to produce positive results, it was also an environmental disaster. The first test took place in January 1965 in northeast Kazakhstan. The Soviet government wanted to find out if nuclear weapons could be used to create reservoirs. A bomb was placed beneath the Chagan River. When detonated, the large explosion succeeded in creating a hole that filled with water. The water near the edges of the crater was also dangerously radioactive. On September 19, 1971, a nuclear bomb was exploded near the city of Kinishma. Although the detonation occurred below ground, rocks and dirt were not enough to completely contain it. Radiation began escaping through cracks in the ground. In 1978, a nuclear device was detonated in Yakutia near the Vilyuy River. Scientists were attempting to force diamond-rich rock to the surface. The test didn't produce valuable diamonds, but it did release large amounts of plutonium into the drinking water. After hundreds of tests, it became apparent that nuclear weapons were not terribly useful. They did successfully extinguish natural gas fires, and it appeared nuclear weapons might make it easier to access oil deposits, but using the technology also resulted in radioactive materials being released into the environment. Thankfully, today nobody is trying to use nuclear weapons for industrial development. What do you think about using nuclear weapons for peaceful purposes? Is it something that should be revisited? Or is it perhaps one of the worst ideas ever considered? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Please? If you enjoyed this episode and want to help our channel grow, then we would like to ask a small favor. Please hit that like button for this video. And if you aren't subscribed already, please do so. When viewers watch, like, subscribe, and comment, then it helps our strange little channel reach a wider audience. Thank you for watching Bad Things in History.